Hi, this is Joe Haller, and in this BaconBits video, we're talking dots. In the Hog 4 OS, we can assign dotted user numbers to any fixture or group of fixtures. Compound fixtures like many multicell LED fixtures will already have these dots assigned. Let's take a quick look on how dots can apply to different fixture types. Here are some simple generic LED bars. Each number after the dot represents one cell. Now we have some pancake lights. A mighty fine one if I do say so, where they have their master, cells, and macro functions all dotted out. Having dotted fixtures certainly cleans up our fixture numbering, but the real power is in fixture selecting. So let's drill down on dots. Let's start with the bars. Note that we're using the console's highlight function to help call out what is being selected. We can select the entire fixture by typing in the whole number or range of whole numbers. Same as it ever was. Want just that one cell? Okay. Type 2.4, enter. Now let's select each bar's first cell. Type 1 through .1, enter. Using the open-ended selection, we'll grab every fixture until there's a break in the whole number. Typing 1 through 12.1 works too. First and last cell? Sure. 1 through .1 plus .8. Now let's get into some evens and odds by using the select toolbar. Type in 1 through 12 and then press enter. Press select, then press even. Even cells, nice. Now let's grab the odds by pressing select, then invert. Now here's a bonus tip. Holding down pig while pressing even or odd selects the whole fixture. Now let's look at the PIX 19. The master is the whole number with nothing following the dot. Dot 1 through 19 are the cells. Dot 20 through dot 22 are the onboard macro controls. Let's get selecting. All the same methods we used on the LED bars apply here. But here are some fun shortcuts that'll speed you up even more. Holding down the fixture button while pressing next or back will cycle through the fixtures as a whole. If we want to cycle through the compound parts, we simply hold the dot key instead. Now imagine this. You're busy making the most epic look ever, and then you realize your lights aren't in the right position. Okay, pressing dot enter grabs just the masters. All focused? Dot zero enter gets you back to your cells. Time to record, and you want to make sure everything's selected? Dot dot enter. As you can see, using a little syntax can really speed up your programming. Let's use some lateral selections to make some quick groups for the SolarPix rings. Pressing dot one enter selects just the center cell. Record that. Dot two through dot seven gives us the first ring. Let's record that. Dot eight through dot 19 enter selects the second ring. And record that. That's all for this video. I hope you find it useful. And as always, if you have any questions, hit us up at hesservice@etcconnect.com.